Hello, it's Sunny Light Matters here, and today, in the fourth video about building flying saucers with stock technologies, we are going to see how to use conical fuel tanks to make the general shape of a flying saucer. Conical fuel tanks are far more thicker than structural adapters or heat sheets, so don't be surprised if the models presented today are not as flat as the others. By the way, if you have not watched the previous episodes of this series, I strongly advise you to take a look at them. This first model is not so big. It is actually pretty simple and is a good example of optimizing the space inside a craft. It can mine, has optimized engines for vacuum environments, and has a good amount of delta V to travel between celestial bodies with little gravity. Robotic parts will help the drills to reach the ground to mine ore, and because some parts are hidden inside the ship, we need action groups to activate ISRU conversion or jettison ore, in addition to the usual action groups we are used to define, such as deploying solar panels, radiators, drills, extending antennas, or even toggling engines. Of course, a craft should be tested because, remember, to test is to adopt and getting a proof that a concept can fly massive kerbals. Launching a saucer is not an issue anymore. You can watch the previous videos to see how large dishes can be thrown into space. Now this time, let's focus on landing. This ship has a good TWR, so reducing speed quickly is not a problem here. Moreover, there are 12 pods equipped with reaction wheels, so these 12 pods combined with 7 engines with gimbal capability provide a very good maneuverability. Sorry, I apologize. Landing this craft was just an excuse to make this stupid joke with a Russian design. The second craft is directly inspired by 2001 Space Odyssey, when a shuttle leaves an orbital station to land on the moon. Here, we will only use the lower and the middle tank to store fuel and oxidizer. The upper tank will be emptied and used as a structural part. Since MK1 crew cabins do not allow Kerbals to get out of these parts, we provide inflated airlocks and landing cans mounted on telescopic pistons. We also provide docking ability with a senior docking port. Before showing the third craft, I have a warning to make. You are going to see an outrageous part clipping sequence. Please do keep the children away from your screen. They should not be exposed to this level of corruption. What we build now is a giant space egg. We seek for 20 meters part to get a maximum amount of fuel and powerful engines to have a huge thrust. The rest won't be that new to you, it's a craft with research, docking, mining capabilities with a large amount of delta V, because for once, we are making an SSTO. This is it, we are in orbit, and we even have 600 meters per second of delta V left to perform a rendezvous maneuver. You know already how to send large oil tanks in LKO for refueling purposes, so going to mainmast to refueling ore is really not an issue at this point. See you soon, and don't forget to test this adapter.